Hi guys, here I am. I'm afraid I couldn't convince anyone else to join me. They all wanted a relaxing Sunday, just sitting and lying in front of the television, watching a series called Squid Game. If you haven't seen Squid Game, the trailer, go and check it out. It's a Korean sort of extreme version of The Hunger Games slash The Purge. Looks fantastic, landed on the 17th of September. But anyway, this is Stranger Things 4. This is the third teaser that's landed. We've had all sorts of teasers before, haven't we? Where Hopper was sort of in a frosted kind of cell in some sort of Russian Siberian ice tank area. We then had the last one, which was sort of set in the hospital where 11, or the laboratory rather, where 11 was sort of manufactured, and we get the suggestion there's lots of other numbers. I wonder if they're all odd. I wonder if they're all odd numbers, thus being odd. And of course, the thing Maddie Kiki really liked about this show is its sense of the 80s, its retro appeal to those of us who love the films of Steven Spielberg, The Goonies, Gremlins, all that kind of stuff. It's really riffing on all that stuff, a little bit like the way that J.J. Abrams' Super 8 movie did. If you haven't seen Super 8, check it out. Great family film to watch. And this great cast, cracking young cast, with Millie Bobby Brown leading the way as 11. And so this is the third trailer. And as I understand it, this third trailer takes a bit of a turn. Most of the previous seasons have pivoted around the strange demogorgons and demodogs, is it? All the creatures that, and the flamethrower or the whatever it was. Sort of creatures from the upside down playing with all of that. And as I understand it, this trailer takes something of a different turn. It moves towards the more, I'd say, conventional zone of horror films or haunted houses and stuff like that. But anyway, I don't want to preempt it. Let's have a look at it. Let's check it out. I personally think season 3 was the best. I also like the way in which the show is always riffing on Dungeons and Dragons. There's a strong tie in there, and that was a game that was very close to my heart when I was a boy, even though I often played it on my own, which is almost impossible unless you have a split personality. So there you go. Sorry, I'm going to turn you off. Let's turn this on. Right, music.
Star shining bright above you.
Children, no running.
Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me.
Could you maybe clarify what sort of clues we're supposed to be looking for here?
The world is full of obvious things which nobody by any chance ever observes. Sherlock Holmes.
I was getting sort of American Horror Story vibes there at the beginning, weren't you? Pretty gruesome, the bunny rabbit. Much more gruesome, what looked like two dead children. And then we punctured back into, well, not the present day, but the present day of Stranger Things. But then on a hunt. And I loved the bag being dropped. That bag being dropped in that way, with the Ghostbusters badge, is all the stuff of those 80s films that I remember. All the stuff. It's just a simple thing. It says a lot. It's beautifully shot. That shot, for me, ironically, was almost the most exciting part of it, because so many other parts of these shows made these days are involving CGI and all that. I like the grandfather clock. I wonder who the family was. I wonder what they're looking for. It's got to be tied with the upside down. I loved Dustin's little Sherlock Holmes moment. They're all a lot older now, aren't they? A lot older. And it makes you wonder how many more seasons have they got in them. Have they said, the Duffer Brothers, how many more seasons there are going to be? Does that get you excited? I'm excited.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.